We are going to continue our titration discussion by now switching to talking about a weak acid titrated with a strong base. Realize these are the only two options we're going to do for calculations: strong acid with strong base or weak acid with weak base. For our example, we are going to use acetic acid. Get my pen tool working here. There we go. Acetic acid with sodium hydroxide again. One thing to consider, the main thing to consider, is that now one of our products is sodium acetate in this reaction. Remember that sodium acetate is a basic salt, meaning that when we produce it in solution, it will affect the pH of our solution, unlike sodium chloride in our previous examples that was neutral and did not affect the pH. So normally in lecture, I start by drawing a beaker with 2 moles of weak acid, 0 base. Again, same type of first point that we had before. We haven't added any base yet. Second drawing, when we add a little bit of base, second or third drawing is 2 moles of base, etc. In the interest of time, we're going to draw what our reaction will look like, or what our beaker would look like, if we have 2 moles of the weak acid with 1 mole of base. For this, I've included a second spare slide for the drawing. And again, we have our acetic acid. Playing with some tools here, we have our acetic acid with sodium hydroxide making water, which is going to be neutral, but now we have sodium acetate being formed. So again, setting up a pseudo change table of sorts. Realize if we start with 2 moles of acetic acid and 1 mole of sodium hydroxide, this means our limiting reagent is our sodium hydroxide. That means that we know the amount of change for everything. Reactants decrease by 1, products increase by 1, because sodium hydroxide needs to get used up and go to 0. That means that I'm left with 1 mole of acetic acid in solution. I do produce 1 mole of water, although it's going to be neutral, and I produce 1 mole of sodium acetate. This one is no longer neutral and will affect the pH of my solution. So the two things that I have in solution here are my acetic acid. Because it's weak, I'm going to show it undissociated as an intact acetic acid molecule. And then we, of course, also have our sodium and our acetate from our salt that dissociate. We do still have water in solution. I'm going to write it off to the right. It's neutral, so it doesn't affect our pH, but it is in there. What I hope you recognize at this point is I have a weak acid in solution, and I have a salt that's made from its conjugate base. Where have you heard that phrasing before? If you said in a buffer solution, you are absolutely correct. And so this region where we have excess acid in our weak acid strong base titration, this region is called the buffer zone. The first calculation that we're going to do here is same as we did for our other titration, is to calculate the volume of sodium hydroxide, 0.10 molar, needed to reach the equivalence point in a titration of 25 mils of 0.10 molar acetic acid. And the Ka value for acetic acid is the 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. So remembering that this reaction will go to completion because we have strong base in here, realize that we're just doing stoichiometry again. And in fact, our setup looks exactly like what we had before when we were calculating our equivalence point for the strong acid, strong base titration. So our first step is multiplying concentration times volume to determine the millimoles of our acid. Our next step then is to convert from the millimoles of acid to millimoles of base. I apologize for the glitch here. I will figure this system out eventually. This is brand new for me. And then our last step is to take our millimoles of NaOH, and divide that by our concentration of NaOH. Again, remembering that milliliters can be calculated as millimoles divided by molarity. I've just literally manipulated our definition of molarity. When I do this, recognize that our final volume of base to reach the equivalence point is exactly the same as the volume we needed for our strong acid titration. Again, because this reaction goes to completion, it doesn't matter that our acid is weak. We need the same volume of base to neutralize this acid as we did to neutralize our strong acid. The other points to consider, let's see if I can figure this out. The other points to consider are that, again, when we are neutralizing our acetic acid with sodium hydroxide, our reaction goes to completion. And anytime we form sodium acetate in solution, so essentially after our first point in titration, anytime we form that, that acetate ion will hydrolyze and will affect our pH because we end up forming some hydroxide in solution. As the last comment in this video, I wanted to point out our titration curve again. We have the same 4 points. The first one is before we add any base. All we have in solution is our acid and how we calculate the pH of that. Region 2 is when we have excess acid, and this will always be the buffer zone. Point 3 is at the equivalence point, and region 4 is after the equivalence point when we have excess base. So our points or regions in the curve are the same as for our strong acid. We just calculate the pH differently. What I encourage you to do is to set up your change tables for points 2 through 4 in our titration at these volumes of base, 0, 10, 25, and 30. Set up your change tables for those, and when we return, I will begin by calculating the pH at each of these 4 points.